This is a very quick introduction to Adobe Animate CC, which we are going to be spending some time on in class. So Adobe Animate CC was released earlier this year in 2016, and it is a rewritten application that grew out of, primarily out of Adobe Flash Pro. Flash had kind of run its course in a lot of ways, and was kind of dying off in some ways, not the least of which was when iPhone and later the iPad or iOS devices said that they were not going to support Flash playing. And so it had kind of started to die off, and Adobe determined that they still had a very good animation tool. They had been working with Edge Animate, which was able to do some working primarily in HTML5. And what they ended up deciding to do was to create one animation tool. And so they took a lot of Flash Professional and parts of Edge Animate and rewrote it into a new program and named it Edge Animate CC because it is part of the Creative Cloud. So that is the program that we are working in here. So it's It is Adobe Animate CC, not Edge Animate, which they are no longer supporting. So, since things were moving in the direction of HTML5 and other web standards, that is HTML5 Canvas and WebGL are incorporated in Animate at this point. HTML5 is used an awful lot at this point for online ads, which is one of the directions we're going to be moving in class, is looking at designing some things that way. It does actually continue to support Flash, which is the SWF file, and Adobe Air formats for that matter. Actually, it can export to the Flash SWF, Canvas, video files, WebGL, and SVG. So they've built it so that it can create a bunch of different file formats, but giving you the one animation tool to work in. So anyway, we are here in Animate CC. I've been staring at my screen, which isn't doing much of anything. And I am in Animate CC here. And I want to do this first video is just a real quick look at how we go about creating a new Canvas document or HTML5 Canvas document. And we're going to start there because it does run natively in the browser. So we're in browsers. It does not require a plugin at all for it to run. So that works out really well for us. So I do have the program open here. I do want to go up to File. Actually, I can even skip that. You know what? We have this open right here. The splash screen is open. Let's go there first, and we can go to Create New, and you see HTML5 Canvas right there. Let's click on that one. And it just brings one up right away. Now, if I had gone to File and New, it would have asked me some questions about setup, and we're going to go modify those right now, because we can view the properties panel over here, and there are different settings here that we would have done if we had gone to the file menu and said new. You know what, one thing I do want to do first, I see my toolbar over here, and because of the smaller resolution that I am running while recording this video, you see it runs right off the bottom down here. So I'm going to go right to the edge, and you see that I can drag it out. And there, I'm going to drag it out till it puts them into two columns. So now I can see all of my tools. So didn't want to lose anything there. Okay, now we're going to go to the properties panel here. You can notice right at the top that this is an HTML5 Canvas document. We're currently untitled, haven't saved it yet. We're going to start down here in the properties. And so right here we get FPS, which is frames per second, or the frame rate. They defaulted to 24. We're going to start with 30 right now as our default, not going below 30. So we're going to start there. And now we can set our size here, the area that we're working in. So it is defaulted to 550 by 400. We can pick a lot of different options here, but at this point, I'm just going to keep it simple. Let's just go with 300 by 300. So we're going to do a little square. And we're going to work as if we were doing this to go, say, on a page. So we can drop this into an HTML page. We could use an iframe and say maybe this is an ad or something that we're going to drop into a page. So let's just use this as our starting point If things get, slid all over the place there, you can come right up here and you see you can center the stage. So pull it right back in the middle there. So that can be helpful. Okay, one other thing I want to change before we do anything on the page is I want to come up here to where it says publish, and my publish settings are here. So I'm going to click on that. With these open, I'm going to leave most of it alone, but right over here I have sprite sheet. And right below that, by default, it is checked. So combine image assets into sprite sheets, and it lets me pick the format, either PNG, JPEG, or both. And by quality, it's in various things that way. So sprites are very useful, but at this point, we're not going to use them. It'll simplify matters a little bit for us if we don't use them just in this testing phase that we're in right now or as we're learning. So I'm going to uncheck that. So you might want to go online and look up sprites and see what they are. Briefly, what they are. You can use this just in your standard web pages as well. The idea is instead of having an individual image file for every image that's displaying on your page, you merge them all into one larger file. And then you control what is being displayed in your browser at any given moment based on CSS. So it utilizes background images. Instead of the image just being placed on the page, because that would be the large image, you do it as a background image in a div that has a set size, and then you work with background offset so that you shift it so that your div is basically acting as a window as to what part of it you can see. Basically, it's cropping it so that you can just see part of it. So that's what sprites are. You can go Google it and get a little more information on it if you would like. But I'm going to turn it off right now just to keep things a little bit simpler for our first files. So with that checked, I'm going to go click the OK button. And now we have our first file. Might as well go up and let's do a quick save. Okay. Okay, so that I found my website folder, 314 folder. I've been working project 2 demo. And I've created an Adobe Animate folder here just to keep these files separate from the things we've done. So I'm going to go into my Adobe Animate folder. A couple different miscellaneous folders in there. Let's create a new folder. Let's just name it. I'll call it First And I can go give it a name. I'm going to name this First Test. And it's .fla. So animate documents are a .fla extension. I'm going to save it. Okay, so I have my file saved now. So I've got all of my starting points in place. So let's see. The one other thing that I wanted to do here is I wanted to look at placing some images on page because I wanted to show you the file that it's working. So we go to import. I'm going to import to the stage. Okay, my working area here is the stage. So import to stage. I'm going to go to my desktop and let's see. Let's go use this Chico folder here. I went and pulled a few public domain photos off of the web a few minutes ago. Actually, they were public domain. They were free to use though. So and I'm just going to grab those first three right there. They're just some little ones. So I'm going to select those and say open. Drops them. So at this point, you can go grab them and select. Okay, just a couple simple pictures. Almost a repeat there. Anyway, have some images that are. So I'm going to go up and do a save again real quick. And then I want to come up here to control and do test. Let's go. That's good. There we go. Chrome opener. So anyway, there is my first test right there. So you can see just what it has created. Okay, nothing fancy. Again, just our first file. Let's hide that away. I'm going to hide this away. And then the other thing that I wanted to go see was, it's not, yeah, let's go to, faucets too. Sorry, you get to look and see. Look at my website. 314. Project 2. Adobe Test. No, first animate file. That's when we're... Okay, sorry. Long route to get there. But what I wanted to show you was there is the project file that I'm working on right now. And then what it has done is it has exported an HTML file. Preview. A JavaScript file. Okay, so there's the JavaScript work, and then an images folder. So no big surprise in its structure that it's creating, okay? It's very similar to what we have done with web pages. So if this is our root folder here, I have an images folder in it, I have an external JavaScript file, and I have the HTML file that has the code for my actual layout. Okay? So pretty simple and straightforward there, but that is creating our first file when we are in the new Adobe Animate CC.